The Gate of God. The building of the Tower of Babel has many interpretations to it. And here we try to capture the essence of the myth or reality of the structure. In biblical literature, the tower was built in the land of Shinar, Babylonia, sometime after the Deluge. The reason given is to explain the diversity in languages among mankind. Apparently, the Babylonians wanted to create a tower that had its head up in the heavens and show the superiority of the people, but God had other plans. And while the structure was on, he confused the languages, thus rendering it impossible for them to complete and disperse the people all over the world. According to Hebrew writings, the idea of the tower was to make man understand that he should not aspire for more than what he can achieve. If we look at the history of Mesopotamia, it is said that the structure's construction of this building began in the time of Nebuchadrezzar I, about 1110. It stood as a building ruin until the reign of Esarhaddon of Assyria, who resumed building about 680 but did not finish. Nebuchadrezzar II was able to complete it. Another version says that three aspects of the language, namely divine interest in and control over its use and development, recognition of the power it gives humans in relation to their environment, and an explanation in linguistics. The NIV Life Application Study Bible notes, the Tower of Babel was most likely a ziggurat, a common structure in Babylonia at this time. Most often built as temples, ziggurats looked like pyramids with steps or ramps leading up the sides. Ziggurats stood high as 300 feet and were often just as wide. Thus, they were the focal point of the city. In conclusion, it can be said that the Tower of Babel continues to be a mystery, and probably man living in different areas and speaking different languages is an offshoot of this biblical myth.